commercial or industrial development projects, visit our website lencogroup.com.au or give us a call today on 1300 152 626.
Are you looking to change your destiny in life? Be your own boss? Start your own business? If you are, you need people who understand your needs and are committed to helping you make it happen. At DKP & Co Chartered Accountants, we are more than just accountants. We are business advisors, taxation consultants, and strategists that specialised in setting up businesses. We understand the client and give them the very best customised advice and strategies to achieve their goals. Visit our website, dkpco.com.au, or give us a call today on 03 9023 9370. Fast, proactive, personal. That's DKP & Co Chartered Accountants.
The Night Train is brought to you by St Andrews Hotel, 128 Nicholson Street, Fitzroy. Beautifully crafted, cosy and intimate spaces for your drinking and dining experiences.
I think the Knights, their time has arrived. I think last week, the 10-man performance in the preliminary final was absolutely exceptional. So I'm going for the Knights.
When you talk of Knights, it's a real fighting team.
Buscock into the back of the net. Melbourne Knights take the lead, 1-0. Melbourne Knights will win the Doherty Cup.
Croatia looking for a finals berth. That's it! The Croatia fans salute the goal. That could be so vital.
And good evening, Knights fans. Welcome back to the Night Train, where we'll be discussing everything and anything Melbourne Knights. I'm your host, Anthony Zovak, and joining me once again is Josh Parrish. Josh, how you going, mate?
Another week, another Knights win.
Another Knights win, mate. Two from two. Look, mate, I don't want to pump it up too much, but we're top of the league.
Hey, you weren't lying when you said in preseason how much the team had improved.
It is...
quite rapid, quite incredible. There will be tougher tests than Port Melbourne and Dandenong Thunder, but so far so good.
So far so good. And look, Knights fans, we've got a jam-packed show for you tonight. We've gone through some junior news, going obviously over the game from Friday night. We've got a few interviews from a few players. We've got a player calling in, and we'll be doing our membership prize where we'll be calling up someone, a random member, and they'll be getting a $50 merch voucher to spend at the club in the merch shop. And Josh, look, I don't mind saying this because it's true. We've got the best merch in the league, mate.
Not even a contest. Not even a contest. I'm not just saying that. Like I look longingly at those tracksuit tops thinking, next paycheck, next paycheck.
Oh, look, mate, and I'm sure you're not alone. So just before we get going, just a quick word to thank our sponsors for the year. So we've got IND Group, Melbourne Croatia Soccer Club, Living Gems Lifestyle Resorts, AHD of Melbourne and Geelong, Empire Global, and sponsor of the show, once again, St Andrews Hotel down on Nicholson Street.
Sensational venue.
You've been?
We had a live show there in season one.
Of course.
So that was my introduction to the venue. Mm-hmm. I had a complimentary Palmer, which was very, very, very nice.
Next time you go, mate, you got to try the steak. Tony does a wonderful steak.
Okay, all right. That's on my list next time. That was a fun night, that's for sure. It was beset with technical contrivances, but we got there in the end, and a great time was had by all.
So we'll kick the show off with a bit of junior news. So our NPL teams had a doubleheader this weekend. They played Caroline Springs, George Cross at Knights on Saturday and were at Green Gully on Sunday. Our under-14s had a 7-0 loss against Georgies, but an excellent game against Gully on Sunday with a 2-2 draw. Our under-15s against Georgies were down 3-0 and an amazing comeback to come back to 3-3 with a hat-trick by Mir Kotsuna. So well done to the young fellow on a hat-trick. Hat-trick last week, hat-trick this week. A few juniors scoring a few goals. Sunday's game, our under-15s was Gully, was full of drama, disallowed goal, 3 penalties against them and a red card. Heads up, boys. It can only get better next week.
Ouch.
Our under-16s lost 5-1 to Georgies, but were super competitive in the first half. They suffered a heavy loss to Gully on Sunday. So same thing, boys. Heads up. fresh result, fresh game next week. Give it your best, and I'm sure the results will improve. And our under-17s had one of the best games of the season with a 2-0 win over Georgie's excellent win. Unfortunately, they were unable to match it yesterday against Gully. In other junior news, we have limited positions available in our under-12s Wallabies team, our under-9s, 12s and under-14s girls teams. For more information, email juniors at melbourneknights.com.au if you're keen to get involved. Josh, we're going to kick things off. We're going to go around the grounds?
Yeah, let's keep the Knights fans waiting just a little bit longer.
Just a little bit. We're going to look, we had you waiting a bit tonight. Just we wanted to tease you a bit, guys. Everyone knows what's coming. We've got a great result to talk about, but let's jump around the grounds first. So we've got South Melbourne, Drew, 1-1 to Eastern Lions.
Well, we said it. South Melbourne can't score enough goals.
No.
And it came back to haunt them in this match. Eastern Lions scored one of the most belting long-range strikes you're likely to see.
If you haven't seen it, guys, go look it up. It was an absolute bomb.
It was crazy.
Crazy.
Absolutely insane. And it was a really emotional moment, I think, for that club. Because obviously on Thursday, early hours of Thursday morning, they lost their longtime mentor, Jimmy Williams, who had a very long and torturous battle with brain cancer, which is just
terrible to hear.
You know, just the absolute pits. And he was in charge for over a decade there and oversaw three championships and three promotions to get them up from relative state league to obscurity to the pinnacle competition in NPL. And they would have done him immensely proud on Friday night, the way they fought for that 1-0 draw against the odds, with players obviously very emotional during and before and after the game. So that was sensational to see. And thoughts of the Eastern Lions this week.
Yeah, and condolences go out to everyone involved with the club. As everyone knows, whenever you lose someone who's that tightly interwoven within your club, it's heartbreaking across the board. So all the best to all of everyone involved down at Eastern Lions. And great result for them on the weekend. Now we've got Green Gully, 1-1 with Hume. Josh, any thoughts on the game?
High quality game. I would say both sides probably in finals contention, but it was a bit of a lapse in concentration from Mark Ocheng at the very end of the match. He just didn't know what was behind him, and it was a nice diagonal ball played to Anthony Polyak, formerly of St Albans fame.
St Albans, and I'm pretty sure he played at Dandy City as well. He's bounced around a bit, Polyak, which is...
Been at every Croatian club except the Knights.
Except the Knights. So, look, maybe we'll give you a call next year, mate.
Well, if we keep scoring goals like that, it was a beautiful finish.
Great finish. Bentley 2-3 to Port Melbourne. Port Melbourne getting their first win of the year.
This was a shock of the round, I think.
Oh, definitely. I was keeping up with the scores sort of while we were all watching the game on Friday night, and Bentley got up, and you're just like, oh, you know, that's it. They're going to hold this out. And then two late goals, and Port dragged the win.
I think a bit lucky with the penalty call, but maybe made up for last week when they didn't get one. You could just hear it in commentator Brandon Galgano's voice. He goes, is that a penalty? Like, it was hilarious. I wish I'd cut up the grab this week. I should have done that before the show.
Well,
it was very funny.
Next week, I think, guys.
Very, very funny. But, you know, they Chris Duggan on the second time of asking off the rebound managed to put that one away and get him off to a good start. But I think it was a little bit smash and grab, I would say. They scored some goals off headers and set pieces. There were some lovely deliveries from wide areas, but two sensational celebrations also on the highlights of that one. One with Jackson Courtney Perkins, who's a new signing there this season, celebrating for the Sharks with a literal shark fin. It took me a while to work out what he was doing, whether it was culturally appropriate or not, but yeah, that was... it was a shark fin. And then, of course, Johnny Cool coming off the bench and doing his trademark, you know, double somersault backflip after he scored that header, which was definitely warranted after a 92nd minute winner. But sensational result for Port.
Always love to see those. We've got Oakley with a 1-1 draw with Heidelberg.
Yeah, Josh. I was calling that game a very tough physical contest. I would say Oakley were the better side, but Heidelberg had some really good spells. It was kind of came in waves, sort of 15-minute spells of dominance and then swung the other way. But I would say Oakley should have finished it off at the end. Reuben Way was absolutely sensational wearing the captain's armband for Heidelberg. Just he was taking long throw-ins from both sides of the pitch, even though he's playing left back. So he had to sprint all the way back to left back every time they cleared a long throw. He just threw himself into every single tackle and put in the cross for the equalising goal. But Oakley should have pinched it late on. They had a couple of ridiculous chances off set pieces that just one went straight across in front of two players' heads from point blank range and no one could get a touch, and the other one that the C parted for Wade Decker, who's usually very reliable in those high pressure situations, but shanked his header over the bar. So they should have pinched it. They were very, very disappointed afterwards, but Matt Thurtell getting off the mark for Oakley, I think, is good for his confidence, and he'll be one to watch this season.
Definitely, and both clubs will definitely be looking to push for finals this year. So 1-1, look, I'm sure Oakley would have preferred the win, but you'll take the point.
No wins in two games for Oakley. A bit harsh on them given performances, but I wouldn't let that fool you because they've come up against some good sides and they've got quality all through that team. So I think they're still title contenders in my book.
Look, as you know, in this league, anyone really can beat anyone on their day. So keep things moving. And look, to be honest, the most controversial game of the round, I'd say, Avondale Altona Magic 2-2.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Crazy. Two red cards, two late goals.
Yeah, and the sportscast people, maybe it's LIGO do the graphics, realized that they'd added a red card for the wrong team. So for 20 minutes, you thought you were watching 10v10, but it was actually 11v9. And then they rectified their mistake. And so if you look in your live score app or whatever, the red card is about 15, 20 minutes later than it actually happened.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Avondale getting off to a two-goal cushion early on. And then after the red cards, you know, they just tried and tried to hold out for the second half. But it's pretty hard with nine players.
Well, look, with that first red card, I really don't know what that defender was thinking. The bloke's clear through on goal in front of him. You know, he's still 15 metres outside the box, and he's ripping his shirt backwards.
Especially when it's Dylan Jacoby, who's one of the fastest players in the league. Yeah. Just back yourself and try and out-sprint him.
Yeah.
He's got... He's got a lot of bags and bags of pace. So that was a silly decision. And then I think the game got a little bit spiteful after that. And it was the second yellow card for kind of a shoulder barge that was maybe a little bit soft.
But look, I think that's in this league, your referees sort of tend to, when the game starts going in that way, they do get a bit card happy. So that's something you do have to be mindful of.
Absolutely. You've got to read the room. And if you can't control your temper, you're going to get punished for it. And Vince Lee scored a nice goal in this game. Fresh from the A-League.
Look, both of Altona's goals late were quality finishes.
Yeah, it was sensational entertainment this one. So, well worth watching the highlights back because it was just bonkers.
And our opponents for this week, Dinamo St Albans beat Dandenong City 2-1 away from home. Great result for them. Good on them for getting their first win of the year.
And Sasha Ognanowski was mic'd up during the broadcast.
I can't, for the life of me, I can't think who in what level of whatever company decided that was a good idea.
Well, he's agreed to it, I guess. You know?
But that's, mate.
Crazy.
Mate, crazy.
They weren't, like, having his mic on all the time or anything. Like, they were crossing to him and he knew when he was supposed to be speaking or whatever. But I do kind of wish they'd had the candid mic on the whole time to hear his reaction after that. But it was a sensational run from Joey Monek. And St Albans maybe proving some of the doubters wrong so far this season, including myself.
All right, guys, we're going to go to a quick break. And when we get back, we are going to be going over our Friday night result against Dandenong Thunder.
Do you spend too much of your valuable time in the kitchen? Chef Good delivers delicious gourmet meals directly to your door. With options as varied as green sambal chicken, Nonna's lasagna and harissa lamb tagine, you'll never get bored or go hungry. All FNR listeners can get 10% off their first Chef Good order. Just head to chefgood.com.au and use the code FNR10. chefgood.com.au. It tastes good.
Hold on a minute. You're saying the Realme 7 Pro can now access 5G? Realme is quickly becoming one of the most popular and affordable phone brands. With a 6.4-inch display, 64-megapixel camera and 128GB of storage, we've found your next phone. Usually $599, it's now on sale for $479. And get a further 5% off when you use the code FNRME on any Realme product. Order the Realme 7 Pro now and get a pair of wireless earbuds, the Realme Buds Q, for free. That's realme.com. Promo code FNRME.
Building or renovating a home? Sick of searching through showrooms looking for the perfect fittings and fixtures in your budget? Renovatorstore.com.au has over 1,000 products to choose from. Browse through the catalogue in the convenience and comfort of your own home. From basins and shower sets to lighting and floorboards, Renovator Store has it all. For a limited time, FNR listeners can get a further 5% off by using the promo code FNR at the checkout. Take your reno budget further. Go to renovatorstore.com.au, promo code FNR.
Whether you're a land developer, in local government, or a service authority, Lenco Group will help you get your job done on time and in a cost-effective manner. Lenco Group provides superior civil engineering and advisory services by creating, communicating and delivering sustainable, efficient solutions. For all your infrastructure requirements associated with residential, commercial or industrial development projects, visit our website lencogroup.com.au or give us a call today on 1300 152 626.
We're this great sporting nation who has yet to embrace fully the world's greatest game, and for so long of trying to have the game accepted.
And when I'm up to the big football field in the sky, I just want people just to remember I told you so.
And suddenly the complexion of the game changes. Let's hope it doesn't, but this is the best period for Iran in the match.
Ali Dodi, danger for Australia here. The flag's down. It's an equaliser.
You just feel for them. Not just the boys. They are representative of so many people who make this game their life. It's just... No, I can't say anything. All right.
Especially as they have the impetus. Aloisi. Cahill. Cahill! Tim Cahill has done it again! What a goal by Tim Cahill! 2-1 Australia! Oh, it's a wonderful moment in Kaiserslautern! And Tim Cahill has come off the bench and maybe won the match for the Socceroos.
You're listening to FNR. Football Nation Radio. The Night Train is brought to you by St Andrews Hotel, 128 Nicholson Street, Fitzroy. Beautifully crafted, cosy and intimate spaces for your drinking and dining experiences.
And we're back. And Josh, I'm coming in this week again with a massive grin on my face. Melbourne Knights 2, Dandenong Thunder 1, second win of the year from two games. Buzzing.
Absolutely.
Buzzing, mate.
And I'm sure we've got someone else waiting in the wings who is buzzing.
We do have someone else waiting in the wings who is buzzing. So coming to you live tonight from Knights Stadium, we have new signing Trevor Zwetsloot. Trevor, welcome to the Night Train, mate.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Mate. We've started absolutely flying. We're 2-2. How's the squad sort of feeling after the result on Friday night?
Yeah, look, great result for us. We started the way that we wanted to, and I think we bounced back from the unfortunate start to the first game really well. And we've used this as, you know, sort of to fuel our fire and training. The energy's been great, and we just couldn't be more excited to get in for our next game, really.
Mate, absolutely magic. So you played in the midfield on in the first hit out against Port due to Nicholas' suspension. You played at centre-back. How did you find that transition personally, moving in from the midfield, obviously, into the back of the centre of the back four?
Yeah, it was something that the team needed at the time, and I'm happy to do that. I found the transition very smooth. I was very comfortable there. And I think the team performed really well. And if I can come in and do the job there, and we're moving the ball about and getting results, then everyone's happy. So, yeah. And I just really enjoyed it as well. It was great to get out in front of the fans. But can't ask for anything better. You know, so.
Trevor, it's Josh here, mate. Tell us about your footballing background and history. You've played for some big clubs and so forth. We've heard a lot about your pedigree. Can you take us through your football journey to date in brief?
Yeah, sure. So I started off in New Zealand with East Coast Bay's Football Club, made my Premier Men's debut at 15. And from there, it was I wanted to go overseas and develop my technique further. So this brought me to IMG Academy in Florida, and was there for a year and a half training, ready to look for my next next opportunity. And yeah, one good result led to another, and I ended up getting a spot at Werder Bremen through a scout, and it took off from there, and played my first season with the under 19 Werder Bremen team. We had a great season, finished up the top of the country there, and continued into the second team, and getting a few trainings in with the first team. So it was really a dream come true.
I mean, Werder Bremen, everyone hears that name and goes, wow. Like, tell us a little bit about the standard over there, the way the training was set up. What was different to football back home?
Look, it was just everything was football. You would wake up, the first thing you would do is you would go to the club and you would have a meal already prepared for you. Get into your first training of the day. You would always have, well, you would usually have two based on when, how close the game is. And everything was just set up for you. It was easy to live a professional lifestyle. And not only was it easy, it was enjoyable. You wanted to do the good things for your body. In order to get a better performance, because really there's just nothing better than getting that win on game day, and everything was ready there for you. So
Trevor, personally, how are you finding your transition? Obviously, you've moved into Melbourne this year just a few weeks ago. How are you sort of finding your transition, and how are you finding the city?
Yeah, I think that because I've done quite a bit of travelling at a young age, the transition was extremely easy. I got into Melbourne early. I actually got into Melbourne early in the morning, slept the entire next day. And after that, I was completely on the time schedule and learned the city really easily, the public transport, all that. And life's really easy here. And not only that, it's enjoyable. Everyone's really kind. And coming into the squad as well, it's just been really enjoyable. So no complaints here.
So how does the move to Knights come about? Does Mark Ivkovic just slide in the DMs, or like, because we've often
Ivkovic really
marveled.
Doesn't mind sliding into the DMs, mate.
we've really marveled at the ability of this club to pull some signings out of nowhere. And you were one where we went, where did he find this guy? How does this approach happen? How do you end up at the Melbourne Knights?
Yeah, I mean, playing in New Zealand, you always have a couple of people that look after you. Never close doors behind me because you never know what's going to happen. And after my injury and COVID, this was a really great opportunity for me. And, the Knights believed in me and wanted to have me here. And that's how it came about, really.
Well, look, mate, you've started well. You've played two really good games to open up the season. How's the sort of team feeling in coming into this week's game?
Yeah. Honestly, getting that 90 minutes under me was really important for me, not only physically but also mentally. I've been through quite a rough injury, and it's important to bounce back and to be strong in this area, to come back and to make a statement. And after getting those 90 minutes under my belt, I just really feel confident, not only in my knee itself, but confident in the team, and also just happy. So, yeah, it was a massive start for me, and I think it's one that's going to help me provide better results going forwards and also the team. So,
tell us about the injury. Is it an ACL or?
Yeah, it was an ACL. And I did it in the Under-20 World Cup at that time. So, yeah, it was unfortunate. But I've done everything that needed to be done to be able to come back as strong as possible. And I also haven't rushed it. I haven't come back too early and said, look, I need to play. I've I've done it right. COVID helped a lot with that, giving me extra time. And I'm feeling fit, I'm feeling strong, and I'm back to enjoying my football. And that's where I feel like I'm most dangerous on the pitch, when I'm enjoying my football.
Well, my sympathies go out to you, mate, because I did mine in 2019 and I still haven't played again. So I'm just telling everybody, you know, Trevor, he didn't rush it. He took his time. I'm sensible, taking my time, mate, as well. I'm sensible. Not doing my rehab exercises. That's the problem.
Well, look, Trevor, it's good to hear that you didn't push yourself to come back. Obviously, we want you fit and playing, if possible, every game this year. How do you feel like you and the new signings have sort of integrated your way into the change room? Because we do have a lot of new signings coming in this year, you being one of them. How do you feel like you guys have adjusted to the vibe in the change room?
Yeah, look, it was quite clear that there was already a big family atmosphere in the changing room. And the big thing was the people that we signed, especially I've noticed in the change room, there's a lot of good people there, not just good footballers, but good people. And we've sort of taken the values that the team wanted to implement into the season, and we've embraced them ourselves. Also, the Croatian culture of the club, we've sort of just embraced everything that the club had to offer, and that made the transition really easy, because we're coming in as family members, not as, you know, new signings. And I think if you see the club, how we come together after a goal, it's very special. You know, everyone's happy and everyone's positive, and that's a big thing for us.
Massive, mate. And look, the whole squad did get around Webby for that goal he scored on the weekend. What was the view like for that goal on the pitch? Because, look, I'm going to make a shout now. That's a shout for goal of the season, that.
Yeah. Look, I've had a conversation with Webby after the game, and it was completely intentional, according to him. So I'm going to back that, you know, class from him on the little volley there. No, it was great. Really, I was just focused on making sure that we were set up for a potential counterattack. But I caught it late and saw it go in top corner. So class from Webby, and got over there to enjoy the goal with him. So
it was sensational. We've got James coming through in the comments. Says that FFA Cup jersey you're wearing, Zovak, almost as wonderful as that second goal on the weekend. So good shout from James. Now, you mentioned the culture of the club, Trevor. Now, speaking of the Croatian culture, well, we've got a Croatian derby coming up this weekend against St. Albans Dinamo. How much have you heard about, you know, the atmosphere surrounding that game, the short trip down the road to the noisy neighbours, who, of course, did something last year that Knights fans would rather forget? How are you preparing for that? It's obviously early in the week, but it's going to be a pretty sensational atmosphere and a high-stakes game.
Yeah, look, it's going to be a great atmosphere, and there's always a little bit of extra tension when you have that derby like that. But we're going to prepare like professionals for every game as we would do another. There's nothing going to change in our preparation. We're going to show up, we're going to do what we do, and we're going to leave with the result that we deserve on the day.
Look, mate, one last question for you. Obviously, you've played at clubs like Werder Bremen overseas. Have you found working under Steve Bearbich as a coach? He's out this season with you coming in so late.
Yeah, so coming in and working with Steve, the big thing was I first wanted to respect what he had built with the club. So I came in and I put my head down. I worked as hard as possible to become a member of the team. And Steve really helped me out with that, including me in everything. And believing in what I could do. And after I've gotten to the top of my abilities now, getting back to full fitness and full confidence in myself, Steve's really just allowed me to be the player that I am on the pitch, really to be confident on the ball, not put about, control the pace to the best of my ability. I think we have a really good relationship and that we understand each other. Love to play for him.
So many positives this season. So much for Knights fans to be excited about, including watching you in the next game. Trevor, keep up the good work. We can tell you've got a great attitude, and that's going to endear you to the Knights faithful.
100%.
No matter how win, lose, or draw, it's the effort, the intensity, and the work ethic that Knights fans really prize above all else.
That's what we can buy into.
So I think you're going to do great things here, Trevor. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for your time, Trevor.
Thanks for having me, guys.
That was Trevor Zwetsloot's new signing at the Melbourne Knights, and he's had a very interesting career so far, and seems as if he's got a really good work ethic and good attitude, as we said at the end there.
And look, that's all you can ask from any players coming into your club, to buy into the culture that exists, help create and further that culture throughout the change room, and put in 150% every weekend during the game.
That's all you can ask for.
All you can ask for. We're going to take a quick short break, and then we'll be back with the recap of Friday night's game.
Hold on a minute. You're saying the Realme 7 Pro can now access 5G? Realme is quickly becoming one of the most popular and affordable phone brands. With a 6.4-inch display, 64-megapixel camera and 128GB of storage, we've found your next phone. Usually $599, it's now on sale for $479. And get a further 5% off when you use the code FNRME on any Realme product. Order the Realme 7 Pro now and get a pair of wireless earbuds, the Realme Buds Q, for free. That's realme.com, promo code FNRME. The Night Train is brought to you by St Andrews Hotel, 128 Nicholson Street, Fitzroy. Beautifully crafted, cosy and intimate spaces for your drinking and dining experiences.
And we're back, Knights fans. Now, Friday night's game, being there, the place was absolutely buzzing, Josh. Mm. There was fans absolutely everywhere. People came out in their droves. Membership sales went really, really well. The vibe before, during and after the game was fantastic. And look, great to get another good result on Friday night, mate.
Yeah, huge. And I think the high that the supporters were on after that battling 1-0 win over Port Melbourne, it was important to keep that momentum going.
Yeah, and, definitely.
I think the more good results and the more good signs that Knights fans see, the more people will be coming through the gates next home game. So,
yeah, definitely.
You know, it's
definitely
about performances on the pitch now. And, you know, it's as important a time as any to get back on the bandwagon if you're a slightly lapsed supporter. You don't make it to as many games anymore because the club is putting its best foot forward for a national second division right
definitely.
Now. So everybody is actually watching. You know, this is, you know, there were a few years there where maybe Victorian football faded into slight obscurity on a national basis.
But
now the
attention
is on the Knights and on, you know, these big clubs around the country who can, you know, and do have the supporter base, the passion, the history to make up a second division. So, you know, you're going to be playing your part if you're buying a ticket and coming through the gate.
Definitely can't stress that enough. And we had a quick chat to Steve Bebic after the game on Friday. Let's have a quick listen to what Steve had to say.
Bear with me here.
Sorry.
The one-man producer show.
The one-man producer show. Bloody COVID.
You know, look, it's public holiday rates. You know, we've got to cut back sometimes. Otherwise, don't want to give you guys a 15% surcharge.
We're going to have to have a chat to your union, mate. Good evening, Knights fans. We're here with our coach, Steve Bebic, post our win. Steve, how are you feeling about the result tonight?
Yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy with the performance of the boys. I thought we were a better team for the full 90 minutes. Obviously, you know, when you can see the goal last 5, 6, 7 minutes, it gets a bit nervy, and maybe some of the supporters had a flashback of last year. But I thought the boys done well today, you know, both with the ball and without the ball, so it ticked a lot of boxes.
Look, speaking from a supporter's point of view, the last 5, 6 minutes was a bit nervy after we conceded that goal, but on a whole, I think everyone that watched the game will see we were obviously the more dominant team over the 90 minutes. Just speak to like how you feel the squad sort of gelling after two wins from two outings.
Look, it's ultra important for the group to get these types of wins. You know, I think it makes it more difficult to get that full belief in what we're doing without the results. Yeah, so even in pre-season there was an emphasis on getting results, and I think we've done that, and that form's carried through. So in terms of gelling and that buy-in, full credit to the boys, because, you know, You know, you can see that they're there and they want it. So, yeah, I've got no complaints at all.
So just speaking to a few of the players, the vibe coming out of the change room from what I'm hearing is the squad is completely together. Everyone's bought into a vision for the year going forward. What's that sort of looking like for you in terms of how the season started?
Oh, look, I think we've done a lot of work. I think, like we've discussed previously, on building the right culture within a change room. I'm a firm believer that if that culture's not there, you can't achieve success. So that was a priority, obviously, going in. And again, full credit to the lads, because everyone's part of it. Everyone feels part of it now. And you can see in the performances so far. In terms of the vision, it is what it's always been, man. Just to make people like yourself and the other supporters proud, man. That's it.
Mate, look, and I don't think he's got a single Knights fan that can complain about the start we've had so far. We're 2 from 2. How are you sort of feel coming into the Croatian derby this weekend against St Albans?
Oh, look, you know, yeah, we've won our first two games, but I think the boys will take a moment tonight to enjoy it, and then by tomorrow they'll forget about it. That's how we have to do. We have to prepare for St Albans. It's a derby, like you said. Churchill Reserve's a difficult place to go to, probably the hardest in the league. Full respect to them, they'll be up for it, and we've got to make sure we match them in that level as well. So we'll see how we go.
Thanks for your time, Steve. So look, just echoing what Steve had to say there, on Friday night I felt like we really were the dominant team. Bit unlucky to concede a bit of a scrappy goal there, because I did pick a 2-0 win last week on the show, if fans do remember. But look, overall, the squad top to bottom played a phenomenal game. The back four looked solid. Young Jack Marth again, he's looking the business.
Yeah, he's looking good. I think he scraps for every single ball. That's what we like to see. And he's got some composure on it as well. It's not easy playing left back when you're a right footer. He's not probably his preferred position. So he's doing well there as a fill-in. And I think that will benefit his game going forward if he gets a bit more experience in different positions and develops that weak foot a bit more. That'll do him loads of good. But you mentioned the late goal. I think it's probably also worth mentioning that it was an absolutely scandalous dive to win the free kick.
Look, I mean, from where I was standing, and this again, look, you don't want to be bashing referees every week, but there always seems to be one or two of those questionable calls that inevitably ends up with a goal being scored.
I went back and watched it a few times, and I went, South Americans, what are you going to do? I used to referee futsal a lot. Yeah. It's always the South
always
Americans you got to watch out for.
Dodgy. And the Italians.
They
we don't forget 2006.
They pursue every advantage they can possibly lay their hands on. Yeah. So, without wanting to generalise, actually, yes, absolutely wanting to generalise.
I'm sure there's some South Americans that are good people, but unfortunately...
Hey, you cross the white line of the football pitch, there's no rules anymore.
No.
But, you know, you've got to be savvy to that and try and make it as clear as possible to the referee that you're not touching him. So I guess that's a lesson learned for Aiden Bryce.
Lesson learned. Look, and the midfield especially, I think, played phenomenal on Friday. James McGarry was one player that absolutely stood out for me.
Oh, he was sensational. Like, he had a lot of time in the ball. They weren't getting close enough to him. And that's partially, I guess, due to his off-the-ball movement, the way he can find little gaps.
Yeah, that's...
Even though he's not the paciest player, he's so intelligent. He's got the first yard of paces in his head. And, you know, he was playing these ridiculous chipped through balls that were just sort of putting all this backspin on them. So they didn't run out of play or run away from the player. They just sort of dropped and stopped where they landed. And it was beautiful to watch. And... both goals, actually. Firstly, the opener from, well, they both scored by Webb, of course, but the opener, it was his ball into the channel that teed up the cross and the eventual, you know, goal mouth scramble. And then, of course, it was his direct assist to tee up Webby for the volley. So
for the goal of the year, mate. That's what we're going with.
And it was his ball to the left-hand side for Webb that nearly set up another goal for Mikulic at the near post. So
correct.
He was all over the park just playing beautiful passes left, right and centre, and I thought he was best on.
Yeah, look, for me, he probably was as well. We did manage to get him after the game as well for a quick interview, and let's hear what he had to say. Good evening, Knights fans. We're here with James McGarry post our 2-1 win at home to Dandy Thunder. James, how are you feeling after that result?
Yeah, good. It's been a long pre-season, and obviously with COVID last year, it's been stop-start a few times, so to get a couple of wins, first two games, good start, yeah.
Look, mate, massive 2 from 2 to open the season. Tough out last week. Played unreal, really, and man, what a ball for that goal from Webby.
Yeah, thanks, mate. Bebba's got us all fit from the start. Pre-season's been very hard, and we've been kept the ball well, and we're looking good. It's been a good start.
Now look, you can see the sort of tactical changes that Bebic has tried to put through the team in terms of how we're playing this year compared to last year. Speak to the vibe in the change room around the difference between last year and obviously last year to this year.
Well, last year the first few games we actually done well as well, and was very unlucky with the sending off and the last minute goal here last year. And then we sort of faded off a little bit, but definitely this year we're a lot more fitter, and yeah, we've got a game plan, and we're all sticking to the game plan this year, and yeah, it's looking good.
So obviously the Croatian derby next week, we're playing St Albans away. The fans obviously like to see us avenge the result from last year. What's the sort of vibe in the change room looking into the game this week?
Yeah, the boys talking about that already. You know, it's a massive game for the club and the Croatian derby. You know, all the Croatian lads they'll get the new boys well aware of how big a game it is on Sunday. So we'll start preparing for that now on Monday when we train again.
Thanks for your time, mate. That's McGarry post the game. And look, I think he's echoing a lot of those sort of sentiments that, and when you look at the result on Friday, I really, if you look back, maybe not, or even last year, over the last 3 or 4 years, the squad 2-1, 2-0 up, you cop a shitty late goal like that, they probably go on to cop another one. You know, I think that really shows the resolve and the difference in the team this year as opposed to over the last few years, that we, even once we conceded that goal, we just asserted our dominance straight back onto the game. And look, there was a nervy cut, like 5-6 minutes there to finish off, but we looked like still the more dominant team to finish the game.
Yeah, it was a couple of set pieces. Like, there weren't that many like chances created in open play, so that might be something to work on during the week. I'm sure Bevich will identify that and tighten up a little bit off the free kicks and corners. But that was really it. You know, the general shape and the discipline throughout at least the first 80 minutes was phenomenal. Yeah. So I didn't really see Thunder threatening all that often. They were pretty good defensively.
Yeah.
But, you know, the Knights had so much of the ball and were by far the better side, I think, very much deserving of the 3 points. But as you say, that discipline to play out the 90 minutes plus stoppages and hold on for a 2-1 win is really good to see. And, you know, you get these moments in games when maybe you haven't converted, you know, the Mikulic chance to go 3-0 up and you haven't put the game away. And sometimes you do get squeaky bum time, but if you can manage that and you've got that in your locker to be able to say, right, we're building the wall, no one's getting past, and that's it. You know, I think that's a real massive positive for the side,
massive,
and a big point of difference from last year.
And again, new signing, old mate Webby, striker, popped up with 2 on the weekend.
Yeah.
Massive. And we had a chat with him as well post the game in regards to his 2 goals and how the team looked on Friday. Good evening, Knights fans. We're here with a 2-1 win at home to Dandy Thunder. Webby, how you feeling? How's the squad feeling about the result tonight?
We're feeling brilliant. I think off the back of last week, I think obviously we got the result, but having gone down to 10, it was more of a grind.
Yeah.
I think in the first 15 last week, we were very good, and then obviously losing the man affected us. But I think today, especially in patches, you know, we've shown what we can do, get the ball down, move it around, and when we do that, teams can't live with us. It's just about, you know, trying to do that more and more consistently, but as well, you can't fault the effort. But it's a brilliant effort from everyone, and it's a good result, and can't really complain. 2 wins in 2, so happy days.
Now look, 100%, mate. 2 from 2. Not one single fan of this club could complain with the start. So given, like, obviously last week down to 10 men through first 15, 20, we look strong. Tonight through patches, we look strong. What's the sort of squad looking to do to try and get that, those patches of solid performance more consistent over the 90 minutes?
I think, as you know, it's a new squad. So it's about sort of, you know, learning each other's games. I think we're getting there. I think there's relationships developing on the field. And I think that's going to come as the season goes on. As I said, all the boys in there are good lads and they want to work for the team, for the club. And I think that, you know, it's going to pay dividends as the season goes on. You know, it's very exciting to be a player at Melbourne Croatia at the moment. So,
mate, that's absolutely buzzing with your goal tonight, mate. What a hit.
Yeah, look, the ball came over and there was nobody in the area, so I just thought I'll have a little dig at it, and yeah, lucky for me, it's gone in. Look, I try those in training sometimes and they go flying over the bar, but that doesn't matter because it's gone in today. So.
Oh, look, mate, when it comes off, it comes off. You look like a genius. Absolutely brilliant goal. So, look, obviously, your first year at the club this year, a couple of games in, we've started well. What have you sort of heard about the Croatian derby this weekend against St Albans?
I've heard about it from the boys. Obviously, playing Adelaide last year, I don't think we played any other Croatian clubs. So yeah, I've heard a bit about it from the boys and know it's a battle. So yeah, we just need to be at it again, really. And look, I think the lads are ready to go out. And when you're playing like this, you want to play tomorrow. So that's how all the boys are feeling. And look, we're just excited to get back out on the pitch. I can only speak for me personally, but the boys, I'm sure, are all the same. So look, yeah, so we're all just buzzing. And like I say, a derby is exciting, isn't it? So it should be really good, and hopefully the fans are behind us. So.
Well, look, mate, hopefully you can drag another bomb next week against St Albans. Thanks for your time, Webby.
Well, look, mate, if Webb gets into a habit of doing that every couple of weeks, he's very, very quickly going to become a fan favourite.
Yeah, I mean, you know, too easy. That was one of the most outrageous volleys I've ever seen in my life.
Look, mate, I haven't seen too many better at Knights Stadium than that one.
It's him, it's Marco van Basten, and that's...
that's your top two.
Yeah, done pretty much.
But look, again, I think this goes to show you what's the work that's sort of been done in the off-season by the club with the signings that have been brought in. Last game, Manos for me was probably the man of the match.
Mm-hmm.
And this week, look, McGarry through the middle is a returning player. But again, Webby stepping up with two to really put the game away with two goals. Massive from two new players coming into the team.
And two such different goals as well. Shows how versatile he is with, you know, one absolute poacher's effort, right place, right time, and one worldie. And, you know, he's got a lot of facets to his game. He's such a mobile striker. He runs the channels. He does all the hard yards in terms of pressing. You know, he combines with the midfield as well. He's not just a poacher or just a target man or whatever. He's got a little bit of everything to his game. And I think him being that dynamic of presence up front just gives Bebic so many more options in the way he wants to play and the service that he can give to his forward players. And, you know, the pace in that final third is pretty frightening at the moment.
Definitely.
I mean, we saw young Trevor Sekamula come off the bench.
Yeah.
Sekamula?
Yeah, I believe so.
But he's got bags of pace as well. Yeah. So, and he obviously, Mo Sumaiora was unbelievable in round one and, you know, had some good dribbles last Friday.
He was pretty good on Friday as well. He looked dangerous. And
I think they targeted him as well. He copped a few big whacks, and that's going to happen because teams do their scouting now with all the games being streamed. But you know, he's going to have more space in other games when other players really start firing. On the other hand, the other side of the pitch, you switch it to Mo, and he's got, you know, isolated with a defender. He's going to kill defenders each and every week. Yeah. So
look, massive result on the weekend. We're going to go to a quick break. We'll preview next week's game, the Croatian derby against St Albans Dinamo. We'll have our membership win prize, and that will just about be it for the show tonight. So we'll see you soon, Knights fans.
Do you spend too much of your valuable time in the kitchen? Chef Good delivers delicious gourmet meals directly to your door. With options as varied as green sambal chicken, Nonna's lasagna, and harissa lamb tagine, you'll never get bored or go hungry.
All FNR listeners can get 10% off their first Chef Good order.
Just head to chefgood.com.au and use the code FNR10.
Chefgood.com.au. It tastes good.
Building or renovating a home? Sick of searching through showrooms looking for the perfect fittings and fixtures in your budget? Renovatorstore.com.au has over 1,000 products to choose from. Browse through the catalogue in the convenience and comfort of your own home. From basins and shower sets to lighting and floorboards, Renovator Store has it all. For a limited time, FNR listeners can get a further 5% off by using the promo code FNR at the checkout. Take your reno budget further. Go to renovatorstore.com.au, promo code FNR.
Whether you're a land developer, in local government, or a service authority,
Lenko Group will help you get your job done on time and in a cost-effective manner. Lenko Group provides superior civil engineering and advisory services by creating, communicating and delivering sustainable, efficient solutions. For all your infrastructure requirements associated with residential, commercial or industrial development projects, visit our website lencogroup.com.au or give us a call today on 1300 152 626.
The Night Train is brought to you by St Andrews Hotel, 128 Nicholson Street, Fitzroy. Beautifully crafted, cosy and intimate spaces for your drinking and dining experiences.
And now to preview our massive game this weekend, Josh, we've got the Croatian derby coming up against St Albans Dinamo away from home. Josh, any of your personal thoughts about the game coming up this weekend?
Well, Dinamo have proved a lot of people wrong, including myself, with that win over Dandy City. I think every single person out of our NPL tipping comp at the station, including, you know, NPL luminaries such as Damir Kulash and Chris Gleeson, everybody picked Dandy City, and everybody was wrong. So Joey Monak, you mentioned before, is looking outstanding. He got a great assist for that hold to a goal right at the end of the game. But they're playing with a degree of discipline that you know, is really good to see. Bagaric had a really good game at right back, I think it was, and he's been very, very solid so far this year. So some of their, you know, nailed on players from previous seasons have really stepped up to fill the breach of some of the guys that they've lost.
That have moved on,
and, you know, that's something that will serve them well in their battle to, you know, avoid relegation and beyond that. And they pinched it from Dandy City in dramatic fashion with a real smash and grab counterattack. So that's what they can do to you, and that's what the Knights have to watch out for this weekend, because I think the Knights will have more of the ball, but you've got to be aware of the pace they have on the break and the way that they can spring forward in an instant. So it's going to be a good game, and I think two teams with clashing styles usually makes for an interesting spectacle.
Yeah, definitely. And look, this is, for us, this is a big opportunity to really stake our claim on where we as a club want to be for this year. We need to be we want to be playing finals football. And look, I believe with the start we've had, every indicator says we're going to be up towards that end of the table. You know, and it's games like this coming up. We've got a couple of games now in this next sort of three or four game stretch, which is really going to show everyone where we're sort of going to be sitting for the year, you know. And these Dinamo games are first game out of that. You know, we've gotten off to a good start now, and it's really important we consolidate that this weekend with a good win.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now we've got we're going to be doing our membership prize now. So, Joshy, let's get the graphic up for that and see who we've got.
We are committed to playing exciting football, to playing with passion, determination and heart.
Sorry guys, just having a few technical difficulties.
There we go.
There we go. And Tom Spalletta. Tommy, how you going, mate?
Hey, Zovak. Hey, Josh.
How are you, mate? Well, now look, for some of you that don't know, Tom's not actually living in Melbourne anymore. He's from interstate, and he and a few others flew down for the game on the weekend. So shout out to you, Tom, and the other boys who came down. You know, Knights have got fans coming from all over this great country to watch us win games of football.
Yeah, definitely. I'd travel anywhere. I've previously been on a few bus trips, as a couple of the blokes would feel us in listening know and would rather forget, or maybe remember. I'm not sure, just can't remember. But they've always been memorable trips, and always willing to travel, no matter where the Knights play. So, it was an absolute pleasure to come down the weekend. So shout out to the rest of the blokes who came from their respective cities as well to watch your great win.
Great win on the weekend, mate. How are you sort of feeling about how we've started the year so far?
Yeah, positive, as opposed to other years, unfortunately. This year seems to be, very, very good two from two so far. And they seem to recruit as well in all parts of the park, whereas in previous years it seemed that we lacked in one area but, you know, benefited in others. But this year it seems to be quite steady all over the park. So, confident that we can keep winning, I guess. on Friday night. A few of the boys got excited on the hill, you know, got the 1-0, said take the heel, take the lid off. And then they got to 2-0. Yeah, definitely kept the lid off. Then they got to 2-1. Put the lid back on straight away. It's a bit of a rollercoaster ride being a Knights fan.
Oh, it always and is, then,
So at the moment, I guess we'll keep the lid, I don't know, east of their own.
Yeah, that's it, mate. That's it. Now, sort of, who's yours? We only played two games this year, but I'm going to be asking this across the season. So who's your sort of player of the squad so far from the Cup first two games of the year?
So far, I think Aiden Bryce is probably my favourite. You know, he was a fan favourite before, and he still is now. I'm glad he's come back because the bloke seems very, very steady and very solid at the back. And, you know, he steps up when he needs to step up, and he commands from the back of the pitch, and he seems to have everybody, you know, playing in their respective positions. And, he just seems solid. He's just a leader.
Oh, look, mate, I don't think you're going to have too many people disagreeing with you. Bryce, he was a great get back for us this year. Now, look, mate, personal question. How many more times can we expect you to come down? Because it's always great to see you down and around the club.
Yeah, I've got a few more games penciled in. I'll be down definitely 100% for the Burgers game.
Mm-hmm.
Probably the South game and definitely the Everton game. They're the games at the moment. Hopefully the wife isn't listening. So.
Oh, look, mate, we'll just make sure this doesn't get broadcast to your bedroom and we should be all good.
Yeah, no, definitely. That's all right. I'm sure... I'm sure I'll manage to escape somehow. I'll have to build a tunnel or something from where I am, if I have to anyway.
We've got a couple of other boys not too far from your neck of the woods. I'm sure we'll be able to get some great escape going to get you out of Sydney.
Yeah, definitely. A couple of blokes in question over the weekend who will surprise everyone out of back in the house, but all things quiet at the moment.
That's it. Now, look, mate, we've got you on, so give us a quick score prediction for the game on Sunday at Churchill Reserve.
Well, I think last year we lost to them, 4-0, 5-0, what it was.
2, I believe, last year.
Was it 2, was it?
Yeah. It felt like 4, yeah, but it wasn't.
It felt like 4.
Different, but same.
So give us
in that respect, I think it would be a reverse result to us, so 2-0.
Oh, mate, I think that's a good shout. Mate, thanks for jumping on. Always good to hear your voice. And
definitely.
Pleasure having you on the show, mate.
No worries. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks for having me on. Appreciate it.
Go the Knights. Look, guys, been a great show. Josh, give me a quick score prediction for the weekend.
Ooh, I think I'm going to go 2-1.
2-1?
2-1.
Look, I backed us in last week at 2-0. We copped a shit goal, so I'm going to stick with the same result. I'm going with 2-0. I really think the boys have got a big opportunity here to set the stage for the year going forward. You know, you make it 3 from 3 and you're really staking a claim on the league. So let's hope for a big result this weekend. Guys, we're going to go to a quick break and then we'll wrap the show up when we come back.
Whether you're a land developer, in local government or a service authority, Lenco Group will help you get your job done on time and in a cost-effective manner. Lenco Group provides superior civil engineering and advisory services by creating, communicating and delivering sustainable, efficient solutions. For all your infrastructure requirements associated with residential, commercial or industrial development projects, visit our website lencogroup.com.au or give us a call today on 1300 152 626.
Building or renovating a home? Sick of searching through showrooms looking for the perfect fittings and fixtures in your budget? Renovatorstore.com.au has over 1,000 products to choose from. Browse through the catalogue in the convenience and comfort of your own home. From basins and shower sets to lighting and floorboards, Renovator Store has it all. For a limited time, FNR listeners can get a further 5% off by using the promo code FNR at the checkout. Take your reno budget further. Go to renovatorstore.com.au, promo code FNR.
And we're back. Now, just to wrap the show up, I just want to give a quick shout out, given that it's International Women's Day, give a quick shout out to our junior president, Susie Corlidge. does an absolutely amazing job running the junior committee and organising our juniors. So Susie, just from everyone at the club and all of us here on the night train, thanks for all the effort you put into the club. It's absolutely very, very, very valued, but your efforts are definitely appreciated and noted. So thank you very much for all the wonderful work you do and all the other women who were involved at the Knights. Your work is very, very much appreciated.
Yeah, kudos.
Kudos.
And, is it time?
It's time, Josh.
In tonight's special feature, we hear their thoughts on where the game has been and where it's heading.
You can't handle the truth.
You want really to say something?
Open up the doghouse. Open up the doghouse. Rover, Rover, move it over. Two cats are coming in.
Open up the doghouse. Who have we got tonight on the doghouse?
Hello, Anthony! It's your grandmother! Hello!
How are you, Bubba? It's always great to have you on the show.
I miss you, Anthony! You make me wait on this line. This line is like the Ring of Obsess in Bombay. I'm waiting 3 weeks now. You know how much my bill is going to be?
Oh, don't worry.
Like, you and Josh are like Harold and Kumar.
Oh, look, Bubba, look, sorry we've kept you waiting for a couple of weeks.
Unbelievable. I wish to complain, please.
Well, look, we've got the producer sitting here next to me, Bubba. You can have a go at him.
I think you'll have to talk to my manager, who isn't here at the moment, so.
I'll get you all.
So, Bubba, how do you think the Knights are travelling so far this year?
Anthony, unbelievable. Friday night, I was like a gremlin. I didn't go home to 4 a.m. I went kill the pup.
Oh, look, Bubba, you ended up at Kelvin. Did you have a slap at all? Did you end up on the pokies?
I win it. I win everything.
Oh, Bubba's done well on the pokies, Josh, on the weekend.
Hit the jackpot.
Did you hit the jackpot, Bubba? I mean, you hit the jackpot when you got me as a grandson, but did you hit it again?
Anthony, I meet someone. Ooh. Oh, I hit a jackpot. Oh, yeah. Very nice, man. Last 12 months I've been on Tinder, but Friday I meet very nice, man.
Not sure what Dida's going to say about that, to be honest.
Hey, that's all right. You know what they say, Anthony? Two's a crowd, three's a lot of fun. It is, don't ask your mom or dad what I mean.
Oh, I definitely won't, because I've got no idea what you're talking about, Bubba.
That's good. No, very good. Friday night, Anthony, I see you shaking over your backside like a tail feather. There's some old ladies, they look at you. Oh, yeah.
Old ladies.
Looking. Yeah. Anthony, when you get married, you're going to lose your hair, Anthony.
Oh, look, Bubba, I think my hair's starting to go now, if I'm honest.
And then some other lady from Geelong, they call you a snack man. I don't know what they mean, but anyway. And then they say yummy in the tummy. I don't know.
Oh, Bubba, thanks for your call. All the Knights fans, I'm sure, have missed hearing your voice on the show. Thanks for the
I miss everyone. You come to Bubba's... You drive home slowly, but Anthony, no detour on the way home, all right? You come straight home.
No detours, Bubba, I'm going straight home.
No, you go straight home, because tomorrow you must be working. No, yeah, tomorrow's no muck around, all right?
All right, Bubba, I'll be careful. Thanks for the call.
Oh, what is bye. See bye. You, Josh.
Bye.
always good to hear from your grandparents.
Yeah, it's a pity a pokies jackpot is going to have to go straight to her phone bill. That's a shame.
Yeah, well, look, unfortunately, we're missing a couple of people that normally are around the show, so we might have missed a couple of calls over the last few weeks. But always good to hear from Bubba and anyone else who wants to call in next week. Guys, that's going to be a wrap for tonight. Hope to see you all Sunday at St. Albans Dynamo. Knights taking on St. Albans. It's going to be an absolutely bumper fixture. Come on down. Come down in your Knights gear. Let's G up the boys for their third straight win of the season.
I might even come down.
Joshy, come on down, mate. Come
I don't
on down.
Think I have a clashing commentary commitment this
well,
time.
Well, look, hopefully so. There's not six games on Sunday like there was last week on
yeah,
Friday.
Yeah, the infinite wisdom of the NPL scheduling.
Yeah.
It's silly, but you know.
Well, look, again, Knights, as trendsetters, we start playing Friday nights. Everyone seems to want to move. So, look, mate.
You're trendsetters.
Oh, I'd say so.
Well, you actually missed the first 2.5 minutes of the game. So, you know, because the graphic was still up, it didn't cut to the footage.
So
the first 2.5 minutes, the viewers were, you know, God knows what was happening. I missed it as well because I couldn't watch live. So I did actually hit up Liger and ask for an explanation, and they said the guy who was responsible for managing all six streams at once, his wife went into labor.
Oh my God.
So they had to sort out a replacement. So there was a few technical hiccups, which I think we can excuse them this once.
Oh, look, his wife's not going to go into labor every week. I mean, if it happens again, then we know he's just giving us a bit of a yarn.
Or he's a bigamist.
Yeah. All right, guys, that's going to be it for us tonight. Hope to see you all at St. Albans on Sunday. Knights are going to be getting the 3 points. Let's go. We'll see you next week.
I think the Knights, their time has arrived. I think last week, that 10-man performance in the preliminary final was absolutely exceptional. So I'm going for the Knights.
But when you talk of Knights, it's a real fighting team.
Buscock into the back of the net. Melbourne Knights take the lead 1-0. Melbourne Knights will win the Doherty Cup.
We are committed to playing exciting football, to playing with passion, determination and heart, to honour the founders of our great club and our 68 years of history.
We are committed to wearing the red, white and blue with pride and playing every match with purpose. There will be no passengers on this team and we are committed to playing as one.
We are committed to giving absolutely everything of ourselves on the park so that win, lose or draw, we can walk off the pitch with our heads held high, knowing that we've done our supporters proud.
We are all committed to our club, and our squad is committed to giving everything, week in, week out. Are you committed to being a member in 2021?